I'll say it. Community was the greatest television show of all time. Now, of course, that's just an opinion. I, or anyone for that matter, can claim any piece of media to be objectively superior to another. What I can do is plead my case on the internet. The internet is full of opinions, and I'm here to talk about mine. I'm just another guy talking about stuff, and this is the start of a series I'm calling The Greatest Television Show of All Time, Community. This is the pilot episode. Community debuted on NBC Thursday, September 17th, 2009, after the season 6 premiere of The Office at 9:30 p.m. The Office, perhaps a show that some other people may think is the greatest of all time, was still an immensely popular show for NBC, even if it was down a million viewers compared to the previous season premiere. It was still a great opportunity for Community to have a show as popular as The Office be the lead-in for its debut episode. Being a big fan of The Soup on E! And its host Joe McHale, I remember being very excited for Community as it was heavily promoted on his show weeks leading up to the premiere episode. Not only was it starring the E! Channel's Anti Seacrest, it was going to be comedy legend Chevy Chase's return to network television. Fans of Community already know there will be plenty more opportunities to talk about Chevy Chase as the series progresses, but that would be getting way ahead of ourselves here. For now, we'll be sticking to the pilot. The pilot's debut was able to retain 93% of The Office's audience to bring in 7.89 million viewers on that fateful night. Unfortunately, that would be the highest rated episode Community would ever have. In fact, the show would never even break the 6 million viewer mark again. But you don't get called a cult hit for being overly popular, do you? It's somewhat difficult to explain what Community is as a TV show on the whole. On the surface, it's your standard sitcom. It has an ensemble cast of characters that get into comedic situations. When you dig a little bit deeper, though, you'll find what the show is really focused on is a study of those characters. Specifically, deconstructing those characters and watching how they interact with each other. The pilot of Community cleverly spells that out for you in the first minute without having to resort to title cards with character traits plastered on the screen. The episode begins with the dean of Greendale Community College, the main setting for the show that almost becomes a character in itself. The dean provides some exposition by welcoming students to their first week of school. This exposition comes in the form of stereotypes. The dean himself is even introduced, fumbling with the audiovisual equipment, setting the bar low for his competence, and by extension, the competence of the school. His speech begins with how people have low opinions about Community College, how it's, and this is a quote from the show, a loser college for remedial teens, 20-something dropouts, middle-aged divorcees, and old people trying to keep their minds active as they circle the drain of eternity. As he rattles off each stereotype, you get an individual shot of a cast member reacting as if though the dean was talking directly to them, giving you a sense of what these characters are doing here, even if it's not for the most flattering of reasons. This way, when you meet these characters later in the episode, the audience already has a little background information before these characters even say a word. Now, if you're watching this, I'm assuming that you already know the show on at least some level, but here's a quick summary of the pilot's plot. Jeff Winger, former lawyer, is attending Greendale to get a legitimate degree after the state bar found out that his original was from the country of Columbia and not the university. He wants to hook up with this girl in his Spanish class. This girl is Britta, the aforementioned 20-something dropout. In order to do this, Jeff introduces himself as a Spanish tutor that's taking the class for an easy credit and ends up pretending to run a Spanish study group in order to get her to spend some time with him. Britta, being suspicious of Jeff, invites other people to his fake study group. Jeff, in response, attempts to get rid of them by verbally manipulating them into fighting each other. As a former lawyer, Jeff's best skill is being able to manipulate people verbally. This show treats this almost like a superpower. Britta then realizes that he was doing this all on purpose and relents to a dinner date if he can get them to stop. Jeff, again using his superpowers, gets the group to stop fighting, only to find out that Britta was lying. She had no intention of going on that date with him. Jeff then leaves, bragging about how he has the answer key to every test he'll be taking for the semester. This was provided by a professor that was a former client of his. But then he comes to find out that the professor didn't give him the answer key because college just doesn't work like that. Then some of the other study group members come out and talk with him after they get bored. and he has to admit to them that he has no idea how to study and will probably fail the quiz. They begin to feel sorry for Jeff, invite him back, and they become an actual study group. It's basically an origin story for the study group we would follow for the remainder of the series, not counting the other, more contrived origin story. But again, we can't get too ahead of ourselves. This is just the pilot. With the plot summary out of the way, I want to talk about another important aspect of Community, and that's the story circle. Now, for a more complete idea of what the story circle is, please check out the Channel 101 wiki. I'll leave the link in the description. But I wanted to touch on the basics because it's specific to the way show creator Dan Harmon tells his stories. What it is the hero's journey broken down into 8 parts. In this case, it's Jeff's journey through this episode. Part 1. Establish the subject. In this case, Jeff is the subject. He's the first character we see driving the plot. We follow him first talking to Abed about Britta, and then talking to Britta, attempting to impress her. Part 2. Need. Something is wrong, and the subject needs to do something about it. Jeff wanted to hook up with Britta, but she doesn't seem interested. He needs to make her interested. Part 3. Go. What will the subject do about the problem? Where will their desire to fill that need take them? In this case, Jeff makes up a fake study group with the goal of getting close to Britta. Part 4. Search. Also known as adapt. Also known as the road of trials. This is the part of the journey in which our subject faces their problem or problems. The fake study group didn't turn out the way Jeff envisioned. Britta has invited other people into the group. Part 5. Find. The subject finds what they were searching for, or at least what they thought they were searching for. Jeff gets the group to stop fighting and thinks he's secured a date with Britta. Part 6. Take. What are the consequences of finding what the subject seeks? In this case, Jeff finds out Britta lied to him. There will be no dinner date. Part 7. Return. Our subject returns to a place of normalcy, but something is different due to the journey. Jeff is alone again, but finds he doesn't have the answer key and admits to the group that he doesn't know how to study. And last, part 8. Change. Our subject has changed as a result of the journey. Jeff is now being invited to the study group, and he accepts their help. Now again, I admit, the story circle gets a little more complicated than what I've just described. If enough people watch this video, I'm sure there'll be plenty of constructive criticism from better storytellers than I in the comments. Again, please check out the Channel 101 website for a more in-depth description of how to apply the story circle. It's pretty interesting stuff. The reason I want to talk about it here is to show how Community tells its stories. Because even the B-plot involving Jeff and Professor Duncan can be interpreted through this story circle. Like I said, the show is ultimately a character study. It takes these characters and through a story shows how they react to their environment and to each other. It deconstructs them to the point where the audience recognizes these character traits within themselves and others. However, the reason I think this show garnered such a cult following was not only were the characters being deconstructed, the entire medium of storytelling was being deconstructed trope by trope. This was achieved through the character of media studies major Abed Nadir, played by Danny Pudi. Lampshading is a writing technique of drawing attention to a story element that would otherwise threaten the audience's suspension of disbelief. Abed was a walking, talking lampshade installer. Since the character of Abed was obsessed with film and television, he would see the reality of Greendale through that lens. Since in reality, Community, and by extension Greendale Community College, was just a television show, that gave the writers plenty of opportunities to play with all kinds of storytelling tropes. This definitely gets more intense as the show goes on, but we do get glimpses of it in this pilot episode. Because another thing Abed allows the writers to employ freely is reference humor. Now, reference humor is basically making a joke out of remembering something, and I'm personally a sucker for it. My favorite part of the pilot is Abed doing the Bender banner year speech from The Breakfast Club. Earlier in the episode, Abed offhandedly mentions the Breakfast Club. Then, while the group is arguing with themselves after Jeff manipulated them to turn on one another, this quiet, meek character bursts out of nowhere, doing an impression of Judd Nelson's John Bender, stunning the group to silence. It gets me every time. The delivery of the line, the absurdity of the timing, Jeff's surprised reaction, the way Abed looks so proud of himself for including himself in the chaos. It's not just the reference itself, though. It's why The Breakfast Club was referenced. What is The Breakfast Club about? A group of people with vastly different personalities forced together that end up learning from each other, growing as people because of each other. And that's what this show is all about. Dan Harmon said he pulled the idea for Community from his own experience going to community college. According to him, while enrolled at Glendale Community College, he became involved in a Spanish language study group and unexpectedly grew close to a group of people that he had very little in common with. That's what's great about Community. As the show progresses, we as an audience get to grow close to this group of people along with the cast of characters. We learn their flaws, and oh my, do they have flaws, but we also get to see how their strengths complement each other. We get to examine this in depth in what might be the greatest half-hour television show of all time, the episode Remedial Chaos Theory. That's again, though, getting ahead of ourselves. This is just the pilot. Television pilots are usually rough. Look at all the examples about legendary shows that didn't have successful pilots. The pilot episode of Community probably isn't perfect. You would think Jeff would know that a professor just can't get him the answer keys for every exam he's going to be taking that semester. That's not how college works. Most of the characters don't have a chance to do much. Jeff is established as the lead. Britta has his love interest. Love in quotations. Pierce gets some screen time because he's played by Chevy Chase. Abed gets some memorable lines like the Breakfast Club speech, but his function in the pilot is basically to deliver the reference humor. And the rest get a few lines to give basic foundation to their characters, but that's about it. Regardless of all that, on September 17th, 2009, 10:03 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, I made a Facebook post proclaiming that Community might be the best new show of the year. The witty dialogue, the setups and payoffs, the flawed but intriguing characters, the show quickly became one of my favorites. One of those shows that you can't miss. Or as NBC would like to call it, must-see TV. And for me, it certainly was. So thanks for watching my first YouTube video. I'm hoping to do a lot more of these video essays, including a review of sorts of every episode of Community. They say talk about what you love, so yeah. I'll be doing some reviews of other things, so please check back soon for those. In the meantime, if you made it all the way here to the end, please give a click on that thumbs up icon. I hear that really helps out with these videos. Feel free to subscribe too. That would be awesomely swell of you. This has been Just Another Guy Talking About Stuff. So until next time, insert witty sign-off catchphrase here. Bye-bye.